Music's always been a sacred little place for me. It's been my own little personal space, you know, where I'll, ever since I was a little kid, reflect on things, express myself.
Here we go, to the edge of the moon. We are blinded for now by the goodness of groove. We are dancing and we're singing with the light of the moon. We are blinded for now by the goodness of groove. If you're coming here with love, or bounce in your feet, then here and now would be a good place to meet someone from a place that appeals to you, and together we can share all the goodness of groove.
I've always tried to select instruments that'll fit the mood of what it is I'm trying to express. And I think because of that, I've come across stuff and I've gone, okay, well, I want to use that with this. And so then I've figured out a way to play it simultaneously, you know, so I've mounted it on something. And then over time, we've just built this stand and I've gathered more and more stuff. I probably will continue to. You probably won't be able to see me eventually. A lot of them are handmade and, a wooden. I've always loved the voices of wood, and I've always been a songwriter. I've always expressed myself through music, and I've sort of combined all of those things with my songwriting, and I got all this stuff now. What I play is called a yidaki. Yidaki comes from northeast Arnhem Land, at the top of Australia. Yidaki was a man who found it about 60,000 years ago. It's made by termites hollowed through the centre. So what you do is you find a tree basically beside a termite mound that's dead from being eaten out. And you just take a little bit of bark off and tap it. And you can hear if it's hollow. And if it's hollow, you cut it off. Get a stick and clean out the termite dust, and it's done. And that's what the instrument is. Mine are just polished versions of that. Didgeridoo comes from the name that white fellas gave it when they came to Australia, from the sound that it makes. Didgeridoo, didgeridoo, didgeridoo. So that's become really, really well known worldwide. Asked me what when I first started playing didj. One of my first, the oldest memory I have is my mum telling me not to do that on the vacuum. And you know the end piece of the vacuum, you know, with a sweeper on the end, and it's like about a meter long. I used to play through that, but I don't think I was breathing at that point. I was only about 4 years old, but I remember my mum going, "What are you doing, man? You're gonna get sick." So when you play yidaki, you've got to breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth, same time. So what you do is you store a pocket of air in your cheeks, and when you need a breath, you use your cheek muscles to push the air out while you take a breath in through your nose to refill your lungs. So you're breathing from your diaphragm, but you're using your cheeks as a reserve for when you need to refill. So you're keeping a constant note. It's a powerful feeling, you know. I get it every night and I play, but if you sit under a tree and play for an hour, essentially you're breathing very, very deep, meditating, you know, and it's the oxygen and your muscles feel amazing when you finish playing. I've always been a live performer, you know. When I record, we set up and record live because I guess everything just goes with each other. I don't really separate it when I record, I just play. I've always been drawn to a live situation. What I do is really, really special to me, always has been, and to have a group of people really connecting with it and vibing with it is really powerful. And I'm really lucky. Everywhere I go, all over the world, I have great people come to my shows, and people bring all their stuff, all their good stuff, and they give it out. You know, that's the lucky part of what I do, I think, you know, is I get to receive good stuff all the time. People are leaving their bad stuff behind. They're coming out to let their souls free and celebrate music, and they're feeding that to me, and it's coming up through me real strong, and then it's coming out of me, so it's like a circular motion. I don't really feel like when I play music that it's me entertaining a group of people. It's like a big celebration of good energy. I'm just sort of fortunate enough to be channeling the energy and making noise.
Then keep a clean set of holes, cause the way that it shines may just dwindle with time. Changes it will unfold. You know, some people just won't understand these things. Looking for your message, but I don't understand. You know, some people just won't understand. Looking for your message, but I don't understand. But I'll hold you up again. And I'll hold you up again. And I'll hold you up again. I'll hold you up again. I'll hold you
when I show these eyes. And I feel you many times. When I show these eyes. So hold nice and long, so get to it so soon. When it is cold, you won't feel so alone. Cause roads that you take, they just crack and break. If it changes, you will find. Each gift that you share, they heal and repair. With each choice you make, you may help someone's day. Well, I know you are strong and may journey long. Now I wish you the best of love. Well, I know you are strong and may journey long. You know some people they just won't understand these things. Looking for your message, but I won't understand these things.
Fire it burns, bring it.